Hi there, I'm from the Passport Immigration and Citizenship Agency, and I'm here to tell you how easy it is to apply for your Jamaican passport. Let's start with page 1, section A. This section requires personal information. If applying for yourself, please insert your surname, first name, and middle name. When applying for a child, someone under 18 years old, their parent or guardian, should fill in the child's surname, first name, and middle name, followed by their place and date of birth. The next step is to write their mother's first and maiden name, which is their surname, before marriage. Next, write your complete address, telephone numbers, and email address. This will help us to contact you in case we need more information. Now for Section B. This requires your marriage information, if applicable. Follow the instructions and fill that out accordingly. Page 2 starts with the signature box. Please sign your signature as you would wish for it to appear in your passport. In the case of a minor, a signature is only required if the child is 12 years old or older. Remember, all adults ages 18 and older applying for a passport for the first time must be present. Children ages 3 years and older should also be present for their applications. Let's move on to Section C, consent for a minor. This should only be completed when applying for a child under 18 years of age. So if this doesn't apply, you can skip this entire section. The child's parent or legal guardian will need to complete this section and provide a valid ID in the event that the application is being done for a minor. The parent's name should appear exactly as it does on the child's birth certificate. Note, fathers can only apply if his name is on the child's birth certificate, registry, or citizenship document. Next up, Section D. Fill this out only if you currently own a passport. Write the details of your most current passport or lost passport information. If the passport is damaged, write a short explanation of the circumstances surrounding the damage or loss. Let's move on to Section E, Declaration of Applicant. This section must be completed and signed by all applicants. Again, the parent or guardian signs in the case of a child. There are three options that appear. The first being the option if no Jamaican passport was ever held or applied for. The second option may be selected if a previous passport is being renewed, changed, or pages exhausted. The third is for passports which are lost, stolen, or unavailable for renewal. And that's it for page 2. Join us in the follow-up video to learn how to fill in the sections on pages 3 and 4. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And visit the description box for links to more detailed information on our website. We hope to see you soon. Welcome back. Thanks for joining us again. It's time for pages 3 and 4. We have already completed the first 2 pages in our previous video. If you haven't seen it, click on the link in the description box below. Today we're moving on to pages 3 and 4 to complete the application. Ready? Let's go. Page 3 begins with Section F, Emergency Contact Person. This section requires the name, address, telephone number, and relationship, friend or family member, for your emergency contact. Next up is Section G, Official Certification. This section must be done for all passport applicants. Note that Section A to F must be completed by the applicant before the certification is done by the certifying official. The signing official is required to know the applicant for at least 12 months to complete Section G on their behalf. If the application is being done for a child, the official should state how long they know the parent or guardian who is applying on their behalf instead. Section H is next, headgear. This section should only be completed if the applicant must wear the hair or head covered, without covering the face or forehead. Example, for religious purposes. Follow the instructions as displayed to fill out each section. That concludes page 3, and we're on to page 4. This begins with section I, parents' information. This section should be completed if the applicant is not Jamaican-born. It requires the applicant's parents' name, date, and place of birth. Here are the documents you will need to provide proof of citizenship. All applicants, whether adult, child, first-time, renewal, or replacement of passport, are required to have a completed and certified passport application form. Two identical photographs, where only one should be certified by the same official who certifies Section G of the passport application. Note, one photograph should be left blank, where no writing is present. If you are Jamaican-born, applying for the first time, an original official birth certificate from the Registrar General Department, not a copy, is required. A valid picture identification card is needed. For example, electoral ID or driver's license. As usual, for the renewal of a passport, the most current passport is required. If a passport is lost, stolen, or destroyed, the birth certificate is still required. If the passport that is lost is the old blue handwritten passport, a valid identification card is also required. Where the applicant has been adopted, the adoption certificate must be presented. If the applicant was born outside of Jamaica, a citizenship or registration certificate should be presented with picture identification, such as an overseas passport or permanent resident card. Any applicant with a court order should also present this document. And that's it. You are ready to drop off your application form. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe, and visit the description box for links to more detailed information on our website. We hope to see you soon.